Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Stacy Hargis. I'm the Entrepreneurship Coordinator here at Middlesex Community College. And I'm going to be talking about my experience in Cambodia and how I've come back and tried to incorporate those wonderful experiences into my curriculum to share with my students. Because I teach entrepreneurship, I was very interested in going to Cambodia to learn more about businesses, and my hope was to do interviews with local businesses to find out what their resources are, how they go about getting started, what the environment is for business starts. And what I found when I was there was a little different than what I was expecting. Obviously, it's a different economic system in terms of what we experience here at the US, but I was also floored by how many businesses really put social responsibility first. Obviously, we met with so many non-governmental organizations, so nonprofits like the many we have here in the US that are trying to solve social problems. But I found that so many businesses were also interested in social responsibility beyond just what we would call corporate social responsibility. There were so many businesses that just their mission was to give back to their people, and I think it was significantly influenced by the history of Cambodia, the lost generation of Cambodia, and young people wanting to change their country in more significant ways than just to be able to make profit and have economic prosperity. They really wanted, from what I could tell and who I talked to, their passion was really about making the country a totally different place. So I came back very, very inspired by that, with the idea that we can learn so much from Cambodia, not only because of the historical, social, and economic history, but also because social responsibility is at the core of what I experienced and saw. So I came back with this philosophy of growing more good. How do we nurture social responsibility in entrepreneurship curriculum? Because entrepreneurship is what I teach. I have the pleasure of working with students that have great ideas and want to try to bring those ideas and create something. And that's very exciting work. I am very lucky in what I get to do. And I always feel like many of our students, their number one goal is to make money. And so, of course, that's what businesses do. And so my own personal passion is to help make all those business students understand that it's not just about making money, it's also about making our world a better place. So I was very fortunate to be able to work with Janet and Lynn to introduce this concept in a much more meaningful way. Much of the curriculum I teach, I try to do project-based learning. So I'm trying to get students to work in teams, to solve problems that are real world problems in some way. And so it was a natural fit for me to bring what I experienced in Cambodia into my social entrepreneurship classroom specifically. It's a new course that just ran this last semester, and the goal is to help students understand the variety of social entrepreneurship that's out there. So it can be everything from starting a nonprofit organization that's gonna solve some specific social problem. So for instance, that could be like the Boys and Girls Club of Lowell. So their whole mission is to get students when they, you know, after going to a long school day, to have them come and be surrounded by people that can help them with their homework, make sure they're getting the proper nutrition. So that's a nonprofit organization that isn't concerned about profits. They go out, they try to get funding from grants, and they're doing so much good in the community. So we talk about what that is, and entrepreneurs still start nonprofit organizations, even though they're not driven by profit. And then we go the other spectrum, where we talk about for-profit businesses, and many for-profit businesses practice social responsibility in the sense that they'll perhaps give their employees time to go out into the community and volunteer during work time, or they make donations to the community. That's social responsibility. Many corporations and businesses practice that. But then there's a whole spectrum in between, which I think is really growing, and younger generations are more interested in sort of this middle ground, and that's the blended value type of companies that are not only making profit, but also driven by social good. And that's what I'm really trying to help make sure that business students at Middlesex Community College understand that those opportunities are there. And so going to Cambodia, I learned all these great case studies that I could share with my students. And so I started the, we all started websites while we were there, but mine was stacyincambodia.wordpress.com. And what I did was I tried to put together some case studies about specific social enterprises going on in Cambodia. And one in particular that I really loved was Friends International. And they actually, what they were doing is not only training adults who had children so that the adults had jobs and were able to provide for their children, but they also ran social enterprises. So this was the first one that I kind of came across that I was inspired by. And so they're training people in, let's say, hospitality, I think also cosmetology. There was also some electrical kind of trade school stuff. But they're running their organization. Yes, they get donations. Yes, they're probably going after grants, but a majority of how they fund themselves is through these businesses, like going to the restaurant, and the income from the restaurant helps support all their programming. So that was the first one I saw, and I thought, my students have to know about them, right? And there's organizations like this in the US, but I don't think we do it as well and promote it as well. So I really wanted to share that with them. And so I have several different examples of places that we went to. Artisans Angkor, 60 Road Studios and Magic, which this was really interesting because it's a recording studio. A recording studio that charged market rates to international business or international artists that would come there to record, charge them a market rate, and in turn they would be able to record Cambodian artists for free. So that was really exciting to see that kind of business model. I have not seen that kind of business model here in the US, especially in the music industry. So tried to put together lots of little case studies so that the entrepreneurship class could read about them, start to understand the different business models out there. And then we got to the exciting project that we were able to do with the Stoklosa School. So basically, there we all are on our first day. So I took, it was about 10 of my social entrepreneurship class students. We went to the Stoklosa, so they had some time in class to learn about what does it mean to run a social enterprise. And to be honest, we did it like true entrepreneurs. We kind of started and kind of let the ball roll. And as it rolled, we worked with it. The students put together some lesson plans beforehand that they were going to provide the fifth grade class about what it means to open a business. And that business was going to be specifically a social enterprise that will, with the profits, they're going to give money to the sister school in Cambodia. They're also going to keep some of the money at the Stoklosa School for the projects going on there. And then we're also going to have a small slice of it go to a Middlesex scholarship fund so that students from the Stoklosa that want to come to Middlesex and want to study business will have an opportunity to apply for a scholarship. So basically, what we did was I want to look at the learning objectives because there were two different ones going on, right? We needed to make sure that the Stoklosa students would understand what entrepreneurship and social entrepreneurship were so they understood what exactly they're doing with the project. And as Janet had mentioned, one of the first things I did when I got there was ask, well, what's an entrepreneur? And it was so fascinating to hear the students' answers. And by the end of that first lesson, I felt like, and many of my students commented, that they understood it better than them. they really grasped onto it really well. And so that was exciting to see that transform. And it was really exciting for me to see my students really learn the process by having to teach it as well. And in the reflections that my students did, a lot of them talked about it. They were like, I learned even more because I had to be prepared and teach it to make sure that these students, they felt a responsibility to making sure that the students understood what was going on. So then the other things we wanted to make sure they understood is how to create inventory for the school shop. And so what we're doing is a pop-up store. So we don't actually have a location, we don't have a cart, but we have a nice beautiful box that Janet has put together. And we have a lovely card table with beautiful fabric that the students taught them how to set it up, so how to make it look nice, how to display it. They talked about the need for putting up signage on it. We had another team of students that were working on inventory, and I'll talk a little bit more about this in a minute, but some of the inventory are photographs that our trip took while in Cambodia. And the other inventory is going to be these beautiful prints that we're going to make on lovely note cards that we can sell, the t-shirts, the Buddha image of the print that we saw earlier will be one of the t-shirts. And so we're always looking for, well, what can we actually sell at the store? So that's an ongoing exercise that we're working on. But the students taught them how to set that up, how to think about inventory, how do you price things, we talked about that. They learned how to make exchanges, so if someone comes up and, you know, how do you make change and all those kinds of customer service necessities. We also, a team also talked about advertising and marketing, how you're gonna get the word out, where do you wanna go to set up your pop-up store, and the students had amazing ideas. One of the students in particular said, well, my uncle works at Market Basket. Why can't we set up at Market Basket? I go, that's entrepreneurial thinking right there. What means do you have and what can you do with it from there? So we were very excited about all that. The students, we went for 3 Friday mornings. We don't have class on Friday mornings. And so my students were so committed to this project that they gave up their Friday mornings 3 weeks to come there and do that. So I was just floored at their energy for this project. So basically that's what we made sure that the Stop Losa students experienced. And from the MCC student experience, it was really obviously understanding the concept of social entrepreneurship, but being able to use the entrepreneurial mindset to approach this project to solve the problem of not only how do you teach these children, but how do you actually get a business up and running? So I feel like we met all our learning objectives, and it is still a work in progress, for sure. So here they are, and here's the students. So as they got up and gave their lessons, so this was the team inventory. And I just also want to note that it's really interesting to see how different students, their different learning styles fit in. And I'll say one of the students here is not an atypical college student. He kind of checked out of most of his classes. But when he understood what the project was, he came on time, he gave everything to this project. And at the end of it, I could tell that something clicked in him that now he's more interested in attending school. So it was fascinating how project-based learning really can help a lot of students. So here's our team advertising. So that was when they were first bonding as their team and talking about what they were gonna do. That's our team inventory. We let the students all choose what team they wanted to be on. And so what the students did was kind of talk about specific characteristics. So if you're gonna be on team inventory, you might be someone that's interested in being organized and researching and looking at different prices and costs for things. And then like team advertising, the characteristics were, are you creative? Do you like art? And so all the students self-identified. And the last one was team operations. So it was nice that my students self-identified what they wanted to be with, and then also the fifth grade class did as well. So it was a wonderful experience. And like I said, it is a work in progress. So we haven't actually popped up anywhere to sell. But as this is a, you know, I always like to say we're building the bicycle as we're trying to ride it. And so over this next year with my upcoming social entrepreneurship classes, I hope to integrate opportunities for them to come do the pop-up in different community locations. So that was that exciting project. And I just had a couple other things that I wanted to discuss about how I incorporated it into my curriculum. So in addition to the Stop Losa project, while I was in Cambodia, I had the pleasure of interviewing, and that's not the interview, that is an advertisement. I'm gonna stop. This is a work in progress. The woman, I can't pronounce her name properly. Salah Palam. She was so amazing. She started this organization, Khmer Artistry. So this was one of the last places we actually went to visit. And she let me interview her for well over an hour and a half. And I'm currently working on putting together a documentary about her responses, because she talked about what inspired her to start her business, and how the root of everything she does is to employ women in the villages, and that sense of giving back to the community, and some of her profit goes back to the villages. So I'm working on her documentary that I hope to have done some point this summer. And I think that I'll be able to have it played on the local access TV here in Lowell. So looking forward to that. When I talked about her and did some of the clips, it's interesting in the social entrepreneurship class to see what really excites my students. And they all were so interested in what she was doing. So I know that when it's done, it'll be helpful to bring into the classroom. And then lastly, just some kind of, before I talk about one thing we all did, which was really fun, you know, you kind of wonder, like, how am I going to incorporate what I've learned and experienced into my classroom? And I want to give a great example of, I teach computer applications as well. And you would think, how the heck are you going to incorporate anything that happened in Cambodia into computer applications, right? Well, one of their projects is, when you're learning computer applications, it's all about how do you take information and put it into applications in a professional business way. And so I have them do research about business etiquette in another country. And so they have to put together a business memo, they have to do a travel budget, and they have to present. And so when I'm talking about the project, I'm using business etiquette in Cambodia as my example to kind of help them understand that it is important to know that out in the world, people have different customs and different ways of doing things, and the importance of being respectful and understanding that, especially when you're going to do business. So it's been really fun thinking about everything I've learned and how do I put it into my curriculum in some ways. The last thing I want to talk about is this, which was our awesome, what exactly did we call it? Visions of Cambodia. So my colleague, Carrie-Anne Gamache, and I wanted to, we were at this art gallery in Lowell, it's in downtown Lowell one day, and we were talking about how awesome our trip was and how everyone took all these amazing photos. And we were like, we need to do something more. And we were sitting in this art gallery that is in downtown Lowell. And one of the things I always think about is, it's wonderful that Lowell has all this great cultural activity, but sometimes I feel like we also do cultural activity in silos. And so I wanted us to present like our experiences in Cambodia, which everyone graciously donated their photography to do this. But I also wanted to mix it. I didn't want to just end up in a beautiful location in Cambodia town in Lowell. I really wanted to do it somewhere so that we could sort of have more interaction between all the arts in Lowell. So that's why we specifically chose that location. So we had our own pop-up art show. As you can see, the photographs were hanging in the window. Between what everyone donated, I think we had like 300 photographs for sale, and we raised well over $1,100 for Cambodia Living Arts and Khmer Magic Music Bus, which were two of the organizations that we met with in Cambodia. So that's thanks to all of you, and it was really exciting to be able to put that together and see it be successful. And some of the leftover photographs will be sold at the Stokvosa pop-up store as well, which is really great. So thank you very much.